And that's why they're gearing up the military to use them against us. And I've always said for over a decade, then they'll start staging mass shootings and saying it's gun owners and militia people. And if you don't give your farm or ranch up when the bureaucrats come to take it, they're going to blow your house up and say you were an Al-Qaeda militia. I mean, all the mainstream TV says white Al-Qaeda is everywhere, and people that talk about the Bill of Rights really work for Al-Qaeda. And there's a bunch of idiots that will believe that. The average American will take the Bill of Rights out and burn it if they tell them Al-Qaeda wrote it. I'm surprised they don't teach kids in school that Al-Qaeda wrote the Bill of Rights.
Are you concerned for the safety of your loved ones? Listen closely to this message from pepperspray.com. Every 22 seconds a violent crime is committed. America has changed, and your personal safety is your first priority. Be smart. Be safe. Trust Pepper Spray instead of your luck. Pepperspray.com is the only website you'll ever need for all of your non-lethal self-defense supplies. Pepperspray.com carries one of the largest assortments of pepper spray and personal safety products on the web. From big to small, we have it all. Pepper spray, mace, animal repellents, stun guns, and tasers. Pepperspray.com also carries a large assortment of products for personal, home, child, and pet safety. Enter SAFE in the coupon box and you'll receive a special discount off of your order. So what are you waiting for? Go to pepperspray.com. That's pepperspray.com. Or call 1-800-908-9988 today.
Big news blitz coming up in the next segment. I'm going to break down the U.S. military trying to take on the American people. That is treason, violation of posse comitatus. The troops take the people on in Mexico. They do in the Soviet Union. They do in communist China. That's not freedom. That's not the spirit of 1776 on this day before July 4th. Guard units trained for militia attacks. So we'll break all that down coming up. Let's go back to the calls. Let's talk to Michael in Australia. Thanks for holding, Michael. You're on the air with Bob Chapman.
Hello, Alex. Hello, Bob. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Yeah, look, just picking up where you left off there about the military. Look, if they're going to be disloyal to the American people, once they're finished doing what they have to do, they're not going to be wanted anymore because they can't be trusted.
In fact, that happens 100% of the time, and I forgot we had a caller from Australia. I would have gone to you early. Hold on, Michael. Let's get Bob's take on that, and you can have a comment back. I appreciate you calling. Yeah, in the Soviet Union and Russia, Pol Pot, Fidel Castro with Caesar, anytime these guys grab power, what's the next thing they do, Bob?
They usually get all of the people who they think are a threat, round them up, and either put them in camps or they liquidate them.
And that's what these Homeland Security reports say. They say the veterans are the number one threat. So they use the vets against the people, they use the troops against the people, and then when they're done, the SWAT team kills them. Go ahead, Bob.
Well, that's what they think they'd like to do, and I don't think it's going to quite work out that way, because people who are in law enforcement and in the American military all over the world are listening to these broadcasts. And my publication is going to embassies, the State Department. It's the most copied publication in the world. It's all over Washington, every issue. And also, I have subscribers who are in the military in both Afghanistan and in Iraq. And I've told them, make sure everybody in the theater sees the publication.
And so doesn't
my
Bob,
publication's going all over the place.
And that's the International Forecaster. People get a free copy of the internationalforecaster.com. Doesn't the system know, just like my films are all over the world, don't they know that by carrying out the tyranny, they're just validating everything you and I and countless others have been documenting was going to happen?
Yes, and they don't care because they think we're just a couple of rogues and they can easily dismiss us or liquidate us or whatever. And, if there wasn't any opposition, they'd create it. And so here's you and I and a handful of other people who are telling people the truth, and they say, so what? They're not going to penetrate enough to make a difference. Well, they're wrong.
Yeah, they
are going to make a difference.
They think the American people are stupid and broke back, and I'm telling you they're not. They're going to wake up. Okay, Australia, go ahead and finish up what you were saying, Michael.
Yeah, actually, I wanted to bring up the swine flu. You mentioned earlier that the UK was hyping this up. One death and suddenly it's a national crisis. We're right in the middle of our winter, as you're probably aware, and we've had 10 deaths from the swine flu.
Whole cities locked down. They're talking about forced inoculations. Tell us what's happening there in the land down under.
Nothing's happening here. I mean, the government basically said this is not a big deal. There's no vaccination, so there's no way there can be forced vaccination at the moment. But as I said, it's not a big deal. It's actually probably one of the quietest flu seasons we've had. So this whole idea that this particular H1N1 is a problem and that it needs to be dealt with when it turns around to your autumn or fall into your winter, it's just a total setup. It's so obvious because H1N1 is not a very deadly flu. But they're hyping it.
Absolutely. They're hyping the vaccine. And just like with the smallpox shot in 2003, they tried to give first responders the shot, but so many died they had to stop. And Tommy Thompson, the Health and Human Service Secretary, refused to take it. Good to hear from you there in Australia. Good day, sir. Please continue to spread the word about the transmission. We love the folks there in Australia. Bob Chapman, thanks for spending an hour and 20-plus minutes with us today. God willing, we'll see you back for an hour with us next Friday. Folks can go to theinternationalforecaster.com and get a free copy of the latest newsletter that comes out twice a week. And tomorrow is Saturday, folks, so request that by email there, and folks will get it. Bob, thanks for your great info. We'll see you next week.
You're welcome, and I'm looking forward to it.
Take care, Bob.